What's up, you guys? Jeremy McGrath here. We are out at Cahuilla Creek MX Park, and today I have the KX500 and I have the KX450. I'm about to rip some laps. We're gonna do a little comparison thing, see which one's more fun. Obviously, ride the 450 quite a lot. Haven't ridden the KX500 since Mammoth, but I'm really looking forward to it. Got the new X-Trig 22 offset clamps, stoked on that. So 500 should be a lot of fun today, and we're gonna see what how they compare. Comparison ride day, but I was going to tell you a little bit about my 500. We did the build this year. I bought this thing off of Craigslist from a guy in Phoenix, and we delivered it out to my JM2 shop, I'd say probably 3 months before June, which is the Mammoth motocross race. And my intention was to build the thing up and just kind of have a fun bike to shoot videos with. Back in my day, I never really got the chance to ride 500s in the Nationals. I was 125 at that time. So that was always been kind of like my thing is like, man, I want to try the 500. And to be honest, you see, you know, the other 500s that are out there, everyone's having a good time. So I thought, well, hey, let's find one, let's build one up. So what we did is obviously Pro Circuit built the engine. Mitch hooked it up, kind of like the old days, build it like Wardy's and Chicken's bike. Kawasaki factories bikes back in the day. Obviously, hens and clutch, pretty important on a big bike like this, especially if you're going to be using the clutch. And we built it up. We put the 19 KX450 brake system on it. So we took the reservoir off from hanging on the frame. So that looks really clean. We got the new brake system on it. Obviously, we left the swing arm, the original swing arm, so that's the original rear wheel configuration, but John Anderson from W built me a cool set of wheels, so we got wheels on it, still same size axle as stock. KX Guru guys helped me with the linkage. We got some Pro Circuit pull rods to change the way the rear linkage feels, which made a huge difference. Shout out to Showa. Obviously, I got A-Kit on this thing, which is, I mean, it's just like a 19450 in the front end. X-Trig just hooked up. For Mammoth, I had 20 offset clamps, and for since Mammoth, X-Trig made me a new set of custom clamps that are 22 offset. So bike's just feeling super good now, really comfortable, no twitch, good front traction. Obviously, it's got the MXST set of Maxxis tires on there that are just perfect for this bike. Decor graphics, I mean, I don't know what else. Renthal set me up with some bars, of course, grips and bars. But pretty much everything you could think of that you could kind of bolt on it is kind of where we went. Custom painted the frame after we did some gusseting here and there just to make sure that it lasts for a long time. Other than that, I mean, my next step is to build, Randy at the pipe shop for Pro Circuit's gonna build me a cone pipe, and I'm gonna get a round carbon muffler like factory boys had in the day. But other than that, this thing's a beast, man. Super fun. Enjoy riding it. Gets a lot of attention, that's for sure. Everyone wants to ride it. And you know, it's funny because back in the day, you remember two-strokes 500s being so like rocket fast. And you know, now with riding a 60 horsepower 450, it's kind of normal. So when you get on the 500, it doesn't feel like, you know, rip your arms off kind of power. It's super fun, super smooth to ride. I think the biggest difference is the seat's kind of, you know, it's got that big rocker in it, And so when you're in corners, you're really sucked into the bike, which feels excellent. But going down hills, you kind of feel like the seat's kicking you a little bit. So I guess if I had my, you know, away with it, I'd probably shorten the subframe a little bit. Maybe make a new seat foam, a little more flat, a little more like a KX450. And then it would probably feel a little more along the lines of what a new bike feels like. But overall, it's a fun bike, man. We're just having a blast. And the thing rips. We rode it at Mammoth, and it's fun to get back out here at Cahuilla Creek today and ride this thing. Track here is always fun. And it was pretty enjoyable to get going back and forth between the KX450 and the KX500. So enjoyed it. It's quite a bit different. I mean, the new KX450 is so awesome. The chassis just handles so good. And these things, you know, they weren't the greatest handling bike back in the day. Pretty much they were a handful when you're on the track. But, you know, for the most part, we've kind of tuned it up where it handles pretty good. I wouldn't say I could ride as fast on this as I can ride on my 450. No way. Maybe a smooth track, maybe. But it's been a lot of years of riding 450, so I'm pretty used to the new four-stroke style. Although I'm a, you know, two-stroke guy at heart, you know, it's just one of those projects. I don't think I would take this bike and line up against a bunch of 450s. But for a two-stroke Nationals, pretty awesome weapon, that's for sure.